The Parliamentary Ad Hoc Committee, which was instituted to investigate allegations of mismanagement of 31 billion shillings for manufacture of COVID-19 vaccines by the Minister of Science, Technology and Innovation, Monica Musenero, has entered day two while grilling the minister. However, today Musenero has protested to be interrogated by members of parliament with the presence of journalists.
Chair, today we would like to continue with the presentation of the projects. And Chair, we had agreed that we'll do that in camera for the sake of protecting the intellectual property. And all these are coming to present the work just the way Jennifer presented yesterday.
The Select Committee Chairperson acted on Musenero's concerns and ordered journalists out of the committee meeting to give the minister a comfortable environment to respond to issues.
To our friends from the media fraternity, maybe you need to understand this, because maybe you may ask why are we requesting you to get out. Actually, the section of presentation is, yes, has something to do with accountability, but largely to show us how far they have gone.
Yesterday, Musenero made similar attempts to bounce journalists from the committee, but she was bogged down by the committee chairperson reading to her the rules of parliament allowing the presence of journalists in such matters.
Even if it is in other fields, if I have landed on your research which you haven't presented, and I become quicker and smarter than you, I will actually own it. That is the whole thing. But when we get to these other issues of accountability, we will always allow you in. And like we did yesterday when we got to the presentation showing us those classified issues where they have reached, we always let you in.
Musenero, who is battling corruption accusations of the Ntunga municipality MP Yona Musinguzi, denied all the corruption allegations put against her, saying the finances of the presidential initiative on science and epidemics are handled by the State House.
Preside does not have a bank account and has not directly received any funds because it was not set up to be a fund recipient. So it does not have those functions. And Honorable Chair, I will explain the flow of money which was released in the letter. Yes, Preside does not have a bank account. It was not set up to receive funds.
She also denied having employed a husband and a nephew at the Presidential Initiative on Science and Epidemics Secretariat, as it was put by Musinguzi.
I am not a director of Preside, and neither is my husband. My husband has never been ever associated as an employee or recipient of anything from Preside, except having his wife diligently work there to serve.
Story by Fred Kajubi for the news.